Welcome back to G-Man Gaming and Reviews. So we're going to continue on with our gameplay series of Tales of the Two Wasteland Fallout New Vegas. I have recently acquired a laser pistol because I needed something with ammunition. And my 9mm pistol is running out of bullets. Also acquired a sniper rifle, which I will put in. Oh, I also disarmed a bomb and got myself my own place. So I have my own place now, which is good to put things. So we're going to put the sniper rifle away. And then we will go and... Hang on, where is... That's the water processing plant. That's the common house.
Each of us shall give birth to a billion stars formed from the mass of our wretched and filthy bodies.
Luxury apartment is this way. Luxury apartment. In his glory. I urge you, my friend. It's not that one, that's Lucy West's house. Is it this one?
I don't think you should mess with that.
Where is it? Holy crap, I don't know where my bloody house is. Should be able to bring it up on the local map. Okay, so it's up in this direction. Yeah, it is. Ah, there it is. That's my house. So we will put the sniper rifle away. Because we're not going to use it. Put the assault rifle away as well. Put the sniper rifle away. Okay. And now, we are going to... We are going to exit... Got to get more purified water for that guy. I think he, if you get him enough water, he becomes a follower. So we're going to... move it. I think one of the things that people said was better about this game than say whatchamacallit. Is that a mine? No, it's not. I think one of the things that people said is better about this game than Fallout New Vegas is the fact that with this game, right? I should probably check that out. Like that building there. One of the things that they said that was much better about this game than Fallout New Vegas is that this game allows you to just go out exploring. Whereas New Vegas didn't allow you to do that because it sort of shoehorned you into going a certain direction, like, because you couldn't just go straight. I remember in New Vegas, you couldn't just go straight forward. You couldn't just go straight forward because you would encounter cazadors. So there was a short method that you could take to getting to New Vegas, but it was very dangerous and it was very easy to get killed. In fact, there was this really, really good knife that you could get by going north, but I don't think many people got it at the stage of the game where it would have been good because you got the pilot light, metal cooking pot, small burned book.
Got to get away! They're burning everything! They're all dead! Burned gray detrite to the ground! Those things, they came out of nowhere! You've got to run! Run!
Sneak increased by one. Very, very nice. Ooh, carton of cigarettes. That's worth a lot of money. So, flame-throwing ants. Okay, hang on. Where is this Super Duper Mart? Okay, I think it's this massive building here. And we got Grey Ditch down here. Ooh, I need to change. I have to say, that's one of the best things about VATS is, I think in, whatchamacallit, in, I took him out. They really love that single shotgun. Ooh, pack of cigarettes. This one's worth more. Go around first. Make sure there isn't anything of use around. Okay, we've got a silence pistol. So he's been taken out. There's another one there. I saw him go in there. There's another one. I think I saw somebody up there as well. Stay out of the light. There's a guy there.
Thank you.
combat shotgun that takes 12 gauge rounds. Very, very nice. Of gauge. There's another guy there.
Somebody open up the... Hang on. Something ain't right here.
Okay.
Dead!
Alright, this will be the last time that I save scum. Some funky physics at work. Oh, we got 32 caliber. This silenced pistol that I got by killing Mr. Burke actually came in real handy. It's a shame that the ammunition, if the ammunition wasn't quite so expensive. It's really come in handy in here though. Okay, so it doesn't have an S on the end. So it's not this or this or this or this. Or coats. Or stops or sides or silks. Or cache. No. Try this again. Five attempts left. Ooh, five attempts. So it can't be lines, and it can't be aces, and it can't be tires.
Greetings, fellow office employee. Please present your valid ID. Warning! Scan failure. Please present ID or exit the building. Intruder.
Okay, well that didn't help me. Got 6 bullets left. We got some Nuka-Cola Quantum. Okay, that's a milk bottle. A vacuum cleaner, Mentats, Rataway, Jet. We've got 6 bullets left. More rounds. I remember when I was playing Fallout, I think Fallout 4, that you could disarm mines. Not that this is relevant because it's a game, but in real life you wouldn't try to walk up to a mine and disarm it. What you would do is you would instead retreat to a safe distance and use something to with a string to detonate it. But this is a game, so you know. Wait till he stands still. And I think that's all of them. Bottle cap mine. I think one of the reasons I really love this game is that when you use stealth, right, you can start to set up using mines and stuff like that. So you can sort of be very strategic. I'm pretty certain that wait a minute. We got more weight from that. Now, I'm pretty certain... some weird ragdoll physics that you don't see in... I don't think I ever saw anything weird like that in Fallout 4. I heard, I remember recently Bethesda was talking about re-releasing like Fallout 3 and Fallout New Vegas, which kind of does make sense because I think Fallout 4 was really good, but in some respects, I remember correctly, there's another bad guy here somewhere. There's going to be another bad guy here. I remember accidentally running into them. A lot of tin cans here. Ooh, carton of cigarettes. I think if I get my survival skill high enough, I can turn dirty water into purified water. Duct tape, duct tape, energy cell, laser pistol, dirty water, laser pistol, bottle cap mine, energy cell. Oh, nice. Oof, that couldn't have been better. I think it's over. Oh, I didn't see that. Another 54 energy cells. How many energy cells have I got now? Alright, so... first thing that we're gonna do is repair. Repair. Now my laser pistol should be... put you there. Repair. Repair. Okay, I think we cannot worry about it anymore. I ended up paying the price for loading that save anyway. If I remember correctly, there's a lot of cans up here. And if I remember correctly, cans are very useful. Okay, that's another entrance. Gonna have to come back here. A Braxo cleaner. If I remember correctly, All right. We will go back to we might as well go straight back to Megaton.
Here. You've done so much for us. I want you to have this. It's all I have to offer you. No, thank you.
Now, how many rads do I have? 6%. Thank you. If I remember correctly, there's a bobblehead in here.
Mighty fine thing you did for this town.
If I remember correctly, there's a bobblehead up here.
Fine thing you did for this town.
You want something?
AM. Let's have a look here. Activate reloading bench. Cookery to metal. Metal cook pot, metal pan, pot. Oh. Box of detergent, maize. Gas bomb, scrap electronic sensor module. Explosives 40. Butter knife, fork, metal, spoon, tin plate. Mutt fruit. That's what you need it for, the scrap electronics. That's what you need it for. Alright, so let's sell the obvious first.
So, how's the scab? Really? You did? You did! Well, alright! Tell me all about it. So, you're saying that they acquired a well-protected stash? I wonder how many other places are hiding treasures behind monsters. Well, keep what you got. Just traded for a big food shipment myself. Here, take a bit, my treat. Tastes kinda great after a while. Oh, and take this. It's an old food sanitizer. Just carry it with you, and it should automatically make most food and drink more, better. Still need to study a living specimen with radiation poisoning. I need someone to research how to travel through a minefield. And that'll cover the first section of the book. Which strikes your fancy? Well, that's what I need your help for, isn't it? I know lots about it from books, but I never seem to get a live example. Not for long, anyway. So I need you to get a bit of radiation poisoning. So I can study its effects. Oh, not a deadly dose, of course. I can fix you up before that. Oh, you're a peach. Or at least some sort of hardy fruit that grows in the savagely irradiated mockery of agriculture we have nowadays. Now, 200 rads should be enough for basic sickness. But if you can get 600 or more rads, my test will be even more accurate. Just make sure you can get back here, and I'll see to it that you're well taken care of.
Alright, now... Ooh, she's got more money to sell, so I can sell the boxing tape. We'll keep the Chinese pistols, and we'll keep the combat shotgun. Get rid of the knife, get rid of the lead pipe. Get rid of the tire iron. Get rid of the Raider Badlands armor. Keep that. We'll get rid of that. Get rid of that. Get rid of the hockey mask. We'll get rid of that ant meat. Get rid of the Brahmin meat. We'll get rid of the mole rat meat because it's going to be taking up space. Get rid of that. Now let's have a look here. Ooh, a grenade rifle. Ooh, a plasma pistol. We're definitely going to buy that because we don't know when she's going to have it in stock again. And we'll buy the plasma pistol as well. Motorcycle helmet, radiation suit. Ooh, buy the purified water. If I remember correctly, I should have some cigarettes. Ammo box. 22 LR plinking. Alright. The ammo. 308 round. 44 special round, 12 gauge round, 40mm grenade. I'm going to keep an eye out for the ammo box. Oh, okay, I shouldn't have had that combat shotgun repaired. Oh, we've done it now. Yeah, Yeah, I shouldn't have had that combat shotgun repaired. Billy Krill's house. That's Moriarty's saloon. I always forget where my damn house is. So we're going to separate things. All right, we're going to call it a day. This was G-Man Gaming and Reviews. Please like and subscribe, and thanks for watching.